Plex, Cody, Jellyfin, MB. You have been hearing all these names, but you don't know what they are and why some people are going crazy over these media server software. Watch this video. Media servers are hugely popular these days. 10 years back, they were used by a tiny population of technocrats. But with the popularity of Raspberry Pi-like devices and the awareness on the data ownership has increased the interest in media servers in the past couple of years. In this video, I'll discuss what is a media server software, what benefits does it provide, and is it really worth the hassle to set it up? Here we go. So what's the big deal with media servers? Imagine that you have a good collection of old VHS cassettes, DVDs, Blu-ray discs. You purchased them in their golden days, or you got them in garage sales. Now, physical media is tend to worn out, so it is only natural to copy them on the hard disk of your computer. Anyways, so you have a bunch of movies and TV shows stored on your computer. If you're too much into organizing, you will probably keep them in different folders based on criteria you set. But still, they will look like this. And that's not the optimal viewing experience. You have to search for files by their names. You don't have any other information available on the movies. This could have worked 15 years back, but in the age of Netflix, Prime Video, Hulu, and other streaming services, this is an extremely poor media experience. Now imagine if you could have the same media files that you own, but displayed like this. You can not only look at the title of the movies and shows, you can read its synopsis. You can see what star cast it has. You can also see the movie ratings that helps you decide whether you should be watching the movie or not. Heck, you can even create your own watch list. You can resume playing the movies from where you last left. It will automatically suggest the next episode you should watch for the TV shows. Now compare this to what you had earlier. That's what a media server does. It's a software that lets you enjoy your local movies and TV collection in a streaming platform-like interface, and thus enhancing your media experience multiple-fold.
Time to thank the sponsor of this video, ANY.RUN. ANY.RUN provides interactive malware analysis and threat intelligence services trusted by over 500,000 security professionals worldwide. With real-time interactivity, ANY.RUN's sandbox lets you safely analyze and engage with threats as if they were on your own computer. Plus, ANY.RUN's threat intelligence lookup helps you find specific threats and enrich existing indicators by searching a vast database of over 40 different types of threat data.
Next, you will ask me, Abhishek, that's all cool, but I still have to sit in front of my computer while I watch Netflix and Hulu on my smart TV from the comfort of my sofa. Well, my couch potato friend, a media server also allows you to stream the content from your computer to your smart TV. Here, I have a smart TV and I have the media stored on my computer with a media server software Jellyfin installed on it. My smart TV and the computer are connected to the same internet connection. On my smart TV, I downloaded the Jellyfin app, configured it to access the media server that is running on another computer, and now I enjoy the local media stream from my computer to my TV, enjoying all this from the comfort of my couch. Actually, that's not it. I can use Jellyfin's app on my Android smartphone and enjoy the same content from the comfort of a cozy bed. How awesome is that? Now you see why people are loving these media server software. If you're enjoying this video, don't forget to subscribe if you have not already. The next question is, should you be using a media server software? The answer is, it depends. If you have a good collection of TV shows and movies stored on your computer, a media server is certainly going to enhance your experience. The actual question is, What kind of effort does it require to set up a media server? Well, if you're limited to watching content on the same computer where the movies are stored, you just need to install the media server software and point it to the directories where you store the files. That's all. But if you want to stream it on TV and other devices, it would be better to have it running on a secondary computer. It will take some effort and time to set it up. Not a lot, but some effort. Some people use older computers. Some people use Raspberry Pi-like devices. There are also specialized devices for Media Center. Like I use Jima board with its own Casa OS that makes deploying softwares a breeze. But this setup will take some effort. Not a lot, but some effort for sure. You need to ensure that the devices are on the same subnetwork, meaning they are connected to the same router. You will have to enter the user password or use Quick Connect functionality to connect to the media server from the device. The main problem you can face is with the IP address of the media server. If you have connected the computer running the media server via Wi-Fi, it is likely that IP address of this computer will change after reboot. One way here would be to set up static IP. This way, the IP address doesn't change and you don't have to enter the new IP address each time you want to watch it on the TV or phone or other devices. I will make detailed video on how you can set up a media server, or more likely, show how I set it up. For now, let me summarize. If you have a good bunch of TV shows and movies locally stored on your computer, you should try a media server software. As you can see, there is a clear advantage of a much better user experience here. There are several such software available. Kodi, Plex, a lot. I personally prefer Jellyfin and I would recommend that to you. Setting up a media server may take some effort, especially if you want to stream content on other devices. How difficult that would be depends on your technical capabilities. You can find a few tutorials on the official project website or even on edsource.com. I will make step-by-step video later. For now, you tell me, do you think a media server is worth your time? Leave yes or no in the comments and stay tuned for more Linux and open source software exploration videos. Bye for now.